Hello all. Today in this lecture, we are going to learn about BEKK Garch model. BEKK Garch model was propounded by Baba, Engel, Kraft, Kroner in 1990. This model is a multivariate Garch model which estimates the conditional mean function and conditional volatility function of high dimensional relationship, which is used to test the volatility spillover between the multi-markets. That means if you are going to study more than one market, or you can say more than one variables or more than one asset, and you want to study the spillover effect, that means whether one asset is affecting the other asset, or one stock market is affecting the other stock market, or one currency is affecting the other currency, that means one variable is affecting the other variable, then we can use this model. It can be said that it helps in analyzing the effect of volatility of stock returns. And whenever we will be talking about this BEKK Garch model, we should be aware that this multivariate Garch are estimated by maximum likelihood. Now the model is specified as HTCC dash plus A dash U T minus 1 UT minus 1 dash A plus B dash H T minus 1 B D dash V T minus 1 V T minus 1 dash, or even we can say this dash to be a transpose D. Now let's see what does this equation mean. Now in this equation, H means the time varying variance and covariance matrix of the time series variable. U denotes the matrix of residuals from the mean equation. A, B, C and D are mean coefficient matrices. V T minus 1 will be equals to U T minus 1, I where U will be less than 0 and U T minus 1, and where U T minus 1 will be equals to U1 T minus 1, mu 2 T minus 1 transpose. And V T minus 1 will be V1 T minus 1, V2 T minus 1 transpose. And this circle will denote the Hadamard product. Now let's see how we are going to write the variance of first asset return. Now if we are going to write the equation for the variance for the first asset return, it will be variance 1. Over here we are writing variance 1 at time period t. So first of all, we are going to since we are already know that this is a multivariate Garch model where you are going to study more than one variable. So first of all, we are going to study the effect of first asset return. So it will, that's why it's written variance of first at time period t, C11 square plus A11 square mu 2 mu square 1 t minus 1 2 A11 A21 mu 1 at t minus 1, that means previous lag, mu 2 t minus 1, that means previous lag, plus a 2 1 square mu square 2 t minus 1 plus b 1 1 square variance 1 t minus 1 plus 2 b 1 1 b 2 1 standard deviation 1 2 t minus 1 plus b 2 1 squares variance 2 t minus 1 plus d 1 1 square v square 1 t minus 1 2 d 1 1 d 2 1 v 1 t minus 1 v 2 t minus 1 plus d 2 1 square v square 2 t minus 1. Now let's see what does all this equation is going to say. Now whenever in this equation you are going to see these square terms, that means this is your square term, 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 these are your square term. So whenever we are talking about these square term, so we can say the square coefficient in this equation always positively affect the asset return variance in the next period. So whatever be the answer, because whenever we are going to square the coefficient, the answer will always be positive. So we can say that it will always positively affect the asset return variance in the next period. That means in the next day. Now if we talk about this term, this coefficient 2A11, 2A21, this is generally very difficult to interpret. Now let's talk about this term 2b11, b21. Now, if this term is positive, that means whenever you are going to see the value of b11 and you are going to multiply it with b21 value and the answer is positive, then it means that positive 2 asset return covariance will increase the first asset return variance in the next period. And after multiplying, if the value is negative, it means that assuming the positive 2 asset return covariance, an increase of 2 asset return covariance very slightly, or you can say weakly, decrease the next day first asset return variance. Now let's talk about this D term, the coefficient D. So this coefficient D will talk you about the asymmetric effect. As I have already discussed about the asymmetric effect, means when the positive news or the negative news have a different effect. That means if the positive news has a 10% effect, so negative news will have a 5% effect. So they are not symmetric, they are not they don't have a similar effect. So now if we talk about this term D11, D21, and your answer is positive, that means when the value of D11 is multiplied by the value of D21 and the answer comes to be positive, it means that when two asset returns have simultaneously negatively shocks, then these negative shocks shall increase the first or the second asset return variable in the next period. Now let's talk about the second asset return. So if you are going to write the equation for the variance of the second asset return, this will be same as the previous equation. The only difference is in the previous equation we have written 1, 1, because this one represents your first asset. Now instead of 1 we are going to write 2, because this 2 represents the second asset. So the equation is same. So in this also, whenever we are talking about these square terms, so these square terms, all these square terms, this one, this D22 and D12 square, these, all these square terms, that means whatever the coefficient of these square terms will be there in the equation, they will always have the positively effect on the asset return variance in the next period. And again, if we are going to talk about this coefficient 2a12 and a22, and it is very generally very difficult to interpret. Now let's see about this b12 and b22. It means again that if the positive 2 asset return covariance will increase the second asset return variance in the next period, and if your answer is negative, then that it means that as we can assume that positive 2 asset return variance and increase of 2 asset return covariance will either weakly or slightly decrease the next day second asset return variance. And again, as we have previously talked, this D will talk you about the asymmetric effect. Now if we are going to get the positive answer after multiplying D12 and D22, it means that when two asset returns have simultaneously negative shocks, then these negative shocks shall increase the first or second asset return variable in the next period. Now let's see how we are going to write the equation of covariance of first and second asset return. That means whenever we are going to find the covariance between these two asset return, so we can write like this, and the equation will be like this. Now let's read how we are going to read this coefficient, or you can say how we are going to interpret these coefficients. Okay, now let's start first of all with this coefficient a11 and a12. If your answer is positive, then it suggests that a shock of first asset return has a positive effect on the two asset return covariance in the next period. Now let's talk about this term a21 and a22. Now if your answer is positive, that means your coefficient, after multiplying the coefficient of these two terms, comes out to be positive, it suggests that the shock of the second asset return positively affect on two asset return covariance in the next period. Now let's talk about this term. Now, if we are going to add the answer of A12, A21 plus A11 and A22, it is very generally difficult to interpret, so we are going to leave this. Now, let's talk about this term B11 and B12. Now, if the answer is positive, it means that increase of first asset return variance has a positive effect on the two asset return covariance for the next period. Now, if we talk about B21 and B22, it suggests that the increase of the second asset return variance increases the two asset return covariance in the next period. Now, let's come to this term B12 B21 plus B11 B22. Now, if your answer is positive, it indicates that the increase of two asset return covariance increases the two asset return covariance in the next period. Now, let's talk about the asymmetry. That means this D coefficient will talk about the asymmetric effect. Now, if this D11, D12 is positive, it indicates that the negative shock of the first asset return increases the two asset return covariance in the next period. Now, let's talk about D21, D22. If your answer is positive, then it suggests that a negative shock to the second asset return increases the two asset return covariance in the next period. Now, let's talk about this term D12, D21, D11 and D22. If your answer is positive, it means that when two asset returns have simultaneously negative shocks, these negative shocks boost the two asset return covariance in the next period. So, that's all about BEKK GARCH model. In the next lecture, we are going to learn how we are going to calculate these coefficient values with the help of R Studio. Thank you.